Clocktown. Clocktown, USA. Exhibit A.
Clocktown University.
Hey, it's Danny here, and just in my clock room.
Hi there, I see you found me in my clock room. Manfred.
Oh yeah, I forgot he had a partner in crime now. Or in fighting crime, fighting.
What's her name? I've forgotten.
I have forgotten also.
Not Sandra. Let's boss our way back here. There's no one here. It's an old typewriter.
Mm-hmm.
It's an old typewriter. Oh, this is like a typewriter repair spot, maybe? Oh, look at this old dude.
Hi there, Manfred.
Manfred, I'm looking to...
Who is it? Scott. Scott Shelby. Do you remember me?
Well, no. I don't believe I've met you at all.
This is Scott. Oh, yes, of course. Well, good to see you.
Isn't it strange that with elderly people, sometimes you can't tell if they're horrified or confused? Like, it's sometimes it's difficult to read which one of those things it is.
What if they're just both?
I repair clocks.
Constantly.
I feel both. Often.
Often.
If I feel one, I generally feel the other.
Like, horrifically confused.
Mm-hmm.
Still with the police.
Oh. No, I quit. Look.
I'm a private investigator now.
Lauren.
She's a...
Oh, yeah, Lauren. Okay.
Hello.
Oh, hello, my young lady. Well, this calls for a celebration.
That's a judgy asshole man. Jesus.
I've just a thing. Wait there.
He's got just a thing.
I'm sure I...
Oh, yeah. Scott Shelby loves a good old bottle of scotch.
Mm-hmm.
Rifle through his things.
Rifle. Mm-hmm.
Do an old man a favor, would you, Scott? Tell him to call back this afternoon.
I bet it's not going to be just a mundane call. Probably is going to matter.
What if it is just a mundane call?
Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Hmm.
I wonder who that could have been. Maybe it was no one. Maybe it was just a nonsensical call.
This game.
It's all gonna come back.
Curveballs.
This is also a very seven kind of spot.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
basically anything that's crowded with crap.
Mm-hmm.
Chink. This little guy's also got giant hands.
Mm-hmm. Big old butcher hands.
I'd like you to have a look at an envelope. I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Whip this thing up.
Let's have a look.
How'd that not get bent?
He's a massive man. Like, that's flush against any part of his body. That's how big he is.
My eyes are beginning to fail.
Poking a little ballerina.
You gotta go get the magnifying glass.
Oh, do I? Sorry, I was looking at what Lauren was up to. He's in the back, right?
Or not. Maybe it's showing you where it is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's being really obnoxious about it, too.
Look, we know we didn't show you where it was. How's your,
No.
Didn't get there?
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh. Danny's in a fantasy football league. Just to get more weird personal information about his interests in life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's for the deep cut fans
mm-hmm.
who've made it this far into Heavy Rain.
All five of you. Because
no,
let's face
it's like
it.
70 something people.
The other 65 views are just me.
I'm
just refreshing it.
You have it's your bot network.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Shape of the T's and the F's is typical
mm-hmm.
of that model.
Mm-hmm. Scott Shelby looks like he knows about that.
Produced between 1907 and 1924.
A hobbit lay here.
No doubt about it.
I like that, basically any expert in the world can be instantly pilloried with a hobbit lay here. And it just shuts them down.
Yeah, more or less.
Like, what are you going to do?
I read an article recently about being labeled expert makes you less accurate. Probably. Makes you just way... It just, like, the fact that you're labeled an expert makes you way overestimate your opinion's accuracy level.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Mm-hmm.
The minute anyone, yeah, that makes sense to me. And also, probably, if you're labeled an expert, you're called on more often to deliver expertise, and therefore you're less considered.
Hmm.
I wonder if that's part of it.
It may very well be.
Would you remember a client named Gordy Kramer by any chance?
Gordy Kramer?
Who the hell's Gordy Kramer? Oh, that's that kid.
Yeah, the kid. But you know, at my age, I'm just lucky to be here, let's face it.
I'm 900. I have trouble. I found a ring and lived beneath a mountain for a while. And then a bitter guy.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. Well, at least the ones who pay.
Ah, yes.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Yes, of course. I keep my...
Lauren's kind of like, no, this is not a good idea. We shouldn't investigate this.
She doesn't have a lot of patience for, like, old people. Doesn't seem like...
Ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired?
Yeah, that would really help us out.
Let me just pull up my Excel sheet.
I've got it. I have it. You know, it doesn't make a lot of sense. I have it stored in QuickBooks.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna let me get my QuickBooks out. I purchased a computer in 1992. We'll know when we get.
The rest of the game, the from their perspective, is just waiting for him to find that record.
Split screen, Ethan's like,
yeah,
I don't know, murdering an elk with his bare hands.
He's gonna kill a man, last time I saw.
Yeah, last time we like checked that out.
I need more scotch.
You can't drink more scotch, weirdly enough.
I know.
Let's see what this old dude's up to.
Hey, Manfred. He's just hello? Literally has his head inside of a... Your call is lost, sir. A police officer what?
He was calling on the telephone. For something.
Where's all this blood coming from?
Probably, I'm gonna guess a wound of some sort.
He's dead.
Dead?
We gotta get out of here.
Oh my god.
What are you doing?
I'm calling the police.
The killer has already called the police. I think he wants us to be his scapegoats. We've gotta get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Bail out that window. That always works.
Yeah.
Well, if we're gonna think about not being here, let's not be here when we're thinking.
We touched since we came in. You better work fast. The police are gonna be here any minute.
Okay, what did we touch?
Scotch bottle.
Okay, boom. Phone.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, there we go. Okay. Okay, what else?
Scotch bottle.
Nothing here.
And the phone in there.
Yep. And what else?
And the little trinket.
And what else? Magnifying glass, son.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's
you,
it, right?
Yeah, you don't even need to do two glasses. It was just the one closest to you.
She drank it, too.
Really?
I think so. No, maybe not. I don't know.
I don't believe so.
Yeah, look, he's doing the wrong thing.
Yeah, you...
Oh, here we go. All right. He seems to be, like, very experienced in scrumming down crime scenes.
We're gonna make this look right.
That's why he quit the police force.
Mm-hmm.
And then the doorknob on the way out. That's it, right?
No.
Oh, trinket.
Also, this doesn't make sense. If the whole point is we need to just solve this crime within 24 hours, like, hopefully.
Well, I
there's
guess,
always
I think
the
leaving
contingency.
The scene probably
yeah.
makes you look like a murderer.
Yeah.
God, are you gonna be much longer? The police will be here any second.
I'm almost finished.
Let's leave.
That's it. We're done.
You get out of Princeton.
Got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from finding us. So
maybe we didn't get everything.
Hmm. What did we miss?
I don't know. Maybe the door? Doorknob? Yeah. Had to do it separately.
That'll be the first place I look.
Lauren will remember this.
I think that may have cost us, for all we know.
So, you claim the victim was killed while you were in his shop.
Yes, he went to get something in his office. A few minutes later, I went in to see if he was okay. That's when I found him.
Well, Bummertown.
Oh, this has game-changing implications.
Immediately, Mr. Shelby. Would have saved us dragging your ass down here.
Listen, we had nothing to do with his murder. We were only there by coincidence. I just wanted to spare myself a few hours declaring I didn't see anything to a police officer.
P.I. or not, Mr. Shelby, don't leave town.
His accent is very strange.
Bodies, remember to call us. Okay?
Okay?
It's almost like Australian.
Yeah, like a nasally Australian man. What if they're going to re-record the audio for the PS4 version?
Well, well, Scott Shelby. You in trouble again?
These men gonna have a men fight. Gonna do men stuff.
Don't sweat. I'll take care.
Just like old times, huh? Oh.
I owe you one.
You want anything at the moment?
Well, I got some ideas. Nothing concrete.
Everyone in this game lies.
Ideas.
Yes.
Tell me about it, wouldn't you, Scott?
Maybe. Me.
Sure.
I don't believe you. I'm a New York cop that's stuck in this fictional French town. I don't even want to be in Twin Peaks.
I'm taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
A man was just killed. How? We don't know.
Mysticism.
I like how...
Like how what? Mysticism?
It's just not even... They're not even bothered by how he was wounded somehow in a room alone.
I mean, they are panicking about it right now. But yeah, at the time, they kind of let that go.
Because I would immediately be like, well, I guess a ghost might kill me at any moment now.
Well, the window is open. The back window.
Yeah.
I mean, so you have to, I guess, the only thing that makes any sense...
Oh, Sherlock.
Well, that's... well, yeah.
What the hell are you... What
She's mad that you're trying to take her home. She doesn't want to go home.
Hey, we need to have a discussion about car safety.
If you're not going to help me find this bastard to kill my Johnny, I'll do it on my own.
That's right. Scott,
did you choose to send her home?
No.
What choices did you make?
I don't think so. I think I was just having a conversation. About concern.
This girl's stubborn as a mule. She'll never let up, with or without me.
What's she waiting on?
I can't just leave her like that. She'd do anything to
find
the guy who killed herself.
Frown Town Central here.
Gosh, what a bleak, sad day.
All right, let's get out of the car.
Did you remorse?
No, I got out of the car.
Laura!
I'm the Zodiac Killer.
Not the origami killer.
The Zodiac killer. He confesses to the Zodiac crimes, and now that's why he's doing this. He's gonna make up for him.
Do anything to hold him once again in my arms.
Caress.
Excuse me, that's a weird caress.
Let me touch your face. It's not weird, I promise.
I shouldn't have talked to you like that. It's just that I wouldn't want to see you get hurt.
Forget it, Lauren. It's Chinatown. It's this shot.
Forget it. Long pause, Lauren.
Yeah, I had to search my memory there.
Forget it.
Don't blame me.
Ethan. It's Mars.
Actual Mars.
Forget it, Ethan. It's Marzipan.
Mars hyphen. Ipan. A-pan.
Mars comma pan.
Okay, just gonna... So this is... You're about to make some real... hardcore
murder choice,
life-changing decision.
This is the
how far are you willing to go?
This is the daughter's apartment from Magnolia, where John C. Reilly.
It looks like the apartment from Seven too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you want? Oh, fuck. I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies. You want to score, man? You gotta fucking call first.
This is a real dong. Come
on. Beat it.
I hate that. Sometimes it just... I mean, it's the age of this controller. It's not...
Like, you think so?
Yeah. It just doesn't register. I have to, like, really whack it.
Fuck! Are you deaf or what? I should get out of here. You're gonna cause me trouble.
There we go. It'll be easier that
Take
time.
Easy, huh? Keep cool.
Or is it just that, have you played on this difficulty before?
Nope.
Yeah, I think so. I think I played it the first time on this difficulty.
Sure we can make a deal.
Huh? It just requires a much sharper motion than it has before.
Oh!
Oh, shit! I hit square. This is bad.
Damn. I don't think. Jeez. Are you trying to die?
No, I thought I had to wait till he appeared. Like every other time I had to shoot in this game. Oh, so no matter what, I can't really get him. Shit. He's gotta run out of ammunition at some point.
Mm-hmm.
Hold it, man. I give you whatever you
this
want.
This is kid's room.
Got dope? I got cash? You want some dope?
Oh my god.
Please. Please don't kill me.
The dude just chased you around the house and tried to kill you, Ethan.
I got children.
He does have children.
My girl, see? This one, Sarah.
You humanize yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And a little one.
See how it's all coming back around? Mm-hmm. Look at all this. I'm making a big... I wish we had the face cam here.
Yeah, I know.
I'm making a big whirly-gig
like,
motion.
Get out of here.
With my finger.
So I like it that they made him a dope dealer to kind of lessen the value of his life. Like, that's the only
strategy.
Whether
we do it or not.
Oh, it's your call.
I'm a father.
Oh! Kunzman just looks at me and is just like nodding knowingly, like that's the only choice.
That's what I feel like this dude would do. He is driven, and he's been driven mad, like fully, by what he's had to do.
There's nothing he won't do at this point.
Exactly. I don't think he's coming back, and I don't think he can come back.
Not from this.
Mm-mm. I don't think in my previous playthrough I did that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I killed the guy.
Wow.
Or I don't. I think I tried not to. I think. You might end up having to do it anyway. I don't know.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm. I'll put it up for a vote. In the gun grip.
Well, the police are probably on their way, right?
I don't know.
I don't know where that came out of.
I want to see the logistics of that happening. That's where the bullets go.
Well, so there's the actual, like, bottom of the magazine, and then, like, the grip implies, like, taking a screwdriver and actually taking the mm-hmm. plate, like, the wooden or mm-hmm. ceramic, whatever material. Mm-hmm.
That might be our thumbnail for the whole thing.
Also, we've had that gun for mm-hmm. the last 72 hours. Mm-hmm. So all of this was pre-recorded.
I wonder if, if we take it as, or we take it as putting a chip in, like, unlocks a code. That gives a live stream. I don't know. But yeah, I agree. It doesn't make a lot of sense when you push on it. I think most of this game, not most, a lot of this game doesn't make a lot of sense if you push on it.
Mm-hmm.
You just gotta let it go.
Mm-hmm.
You got Christopher Nolan.
We gotta get out of here before,
Look at this.
Whoa.
You should feel bad. That's an infinitely more successful you should feel bad than most games.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Really, impugning the player there, though.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't Ethan that saw that. It was us.
He knows it in his mind, though.
He knows it in
his
mind.
He's a broken man.
In his mind organ.
Dad, it's Sam. I got your information.
My mind organ. You know, as a kid, I understood things in my mind organ better than others. That's like any character in the Green Mile.
A lot of junkies, a lot of dope in this Philadelphia imagining.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of
rain.
A lot of rain. One could even say...
Hey, Matt, be careful, okay?
No.
Go ahead.
Nah.
No, go ahead.
Look at this. It's flash flooding.
Yeah, she needs to get some different pants. Some, like, quick dry pants. That's what I would wear.
Yeah. The owner of the apartment, like, some Under Armour type.
I'd rent a car this week.
It'd be worth it.
I don't have the money to rent a car. I would do it. I wouldn't leave my home. I wouldn't get embroiled in a murder mystery this week. It's too wet.
Hello.
Yeah, this dude's super creepy.
It's an elf. I was told that you could get Betropin. It's an old elf.
Betropin? Why does she need this? Was I even paying attention to this? You were misinformed. Goodbye.
Hold on. I really need your help here. I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say so?
Betropin.
Oh, why didn't you say so? Please come in after saying, hey, I really want it and I'll give you money.
Look at him looking at her butt.
Mm-hmm.
Why, yes, I do murder for money.
You're looking for Betropin.
And fun.
Are you having trouble sleeping?
They love wallpaper in Philadelphia in 2011.
In France.
in France-adelphia. France.
Look at that weird carpet tile.
Yeah.
No, I don't want to drink.
No, thanks.
You know, it's gonna go bad.
Alcohol helps take the edge off the pills, don't you think? Anyway, we should drink a toast to our first deal.
Talk about creep. She has only been introduced to creepy people. Was there like some
and been
voice
a creep?
Was the yeah? She yeah. Was there like some voiceover we were missing about why she's here?
Oh, sure, certainly. No, there was a, like, as we were talking about, you know, a lot of prison, a lot of dope, a lot of drugs. Yeah, she was, like, on the phone, or it was a recording of a previous conversation.
Okay.
I met a guy at a party. He popped some Betropin. Told me he got it from you. I heard you had some apartments for rent. I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked up.
Oh.
Shame. I was looking for something around Marble Street.
What's that? I don't know what that means.
I feel like us as a viewer should be being more diligent about...
Marble Street?
about knowing what's going on in this game.
Oh, so I can't talk over the whole game? No.
I'm not really thirsty.
Get a coaster!
I'll get you a coaster. You're a monster. Oh, look at that little creepy Victorian there. Middle ageist.
Medical book.
I better take a look around to see if I can find anything before he gets back.
Anything. Like this medical book.
He knows a doctrine. He's got a really weird phone. I can teleport. Alright, what's this?
Just one drawer.
Oh, wow, that's like a whole bushel.
It's a bushel of sleeping pills.
You see him, right?
Yep.
That bucket there?
Mm-hmm.